Welcome to our new lecture series on human resource management. In this lecture series, we are hoping to discuss areas like job design, job analysis, HR planning, recruitment and selection, performance management, reward management, training and development, and some other areas that are important with regard to human resource management. In this video, I'm going to give you all a basic introduction about human resource management. So we'll move on to the next slide to see the topics which I will be covering in this video. The first topic is, what is human resource management? And then, what is strategic HRM? Then the importance of HRM. After that, the differences between personal management and HRM. The differences between traditional HRM and strategic HRM. Then the line and staff aspects of HRM. And finally, I will mention the main functions of HRM. Our first topic, what is human resource management? First, let's look at this definition in the slide. It says that the process of acquiring, training, appraising, and compensating employees and of attending to their labor relations, health and safety, and fairness concerns. So what is meant by acquiring here is hiring of employees, which includes recruitment, selection, and placement. After the acquisition, the organization has to provide training for those employees with regard to tasks that are new for them. And also, the organization should appraise the performance of their employees and provide compensation for them in certain situations. In this process, the organization is required to attend the labor relations concerning their employees and to provide requisite health and safety procedures, conditions, and practices. And also, they have to focus on equity, which means the fair treatment. So, as you all can understand, this HRM process involves several key aspects that an organization needs to focus on with regard to the managing of their human resource, which is the most valuable asset of an organization. In this slide, I have given you all a brief definition on HRM, which is easy for you all to understand and to keep in mind. It says that it is the approach of recruiting, utilizing, developing, and retaining the human resource of an organization in an effective and efficient manner in order to achieve the organizational objectives. For this purpose, the organization may follow suitable tools, policies, procedures, and practices. For an example, assessment techniques and testing methods such as coaching, mentoring can be followed here. In conclusion, HRM is a strategic and integrated approach of recruiting, utilizing, developing, and retaining the human resource of an organization in order to achieve organizational objectives. Second topic is, what is strategic HRM? Here, I have included a definition. It says that strategic human resource management means formulating and executing human resource policies and practices that produce the employee competencies and behaviors the company needs to achieve its strategic aims. This simply means that the organization's HR policies and procedures should be linked with the strategic aims or plans of the organization. It aims to ensure that the organization has a skilled and committed workforce that is essential to achieve their long-term tactical plans. I will discuss the importance of HRM. It is a well-known fact that employees are the most valuable asset of an organization. Therefore, the effective and efficient management of this resource will provide a good platform for achieving organizational goals. Then, competitive advantage is crucial for an organization to survive in today's global market. Therefore, it is important to manage human resource as a basis for achieving competitive advantage. Human capital is a valuable asset which is in the form of knowledge, skills, and talent that can be utilized in influencing and enhancing the productivity of their organization. Therefore, HRM acts as a key drive towards developing this intangible and valuable asset. And also, HRM is important as it will enable an organization to face the challenges of globalization. And finally, HRM is significant in ensuring the sustainable growth of the organization. So we'll move on to the next slide. Now I will discuss the differences between personal management and HRM. In personal management, employees are treated as objects or tools, whereas in human resource management, they are treated as a valuable asset or an important resource of the organization. Personal management focuses on managing people with the objective of achieving organizational goals, but human resource management focuses on integrating human resource needs with individual needs with the view of developing their employees. In personal management, the control is external, whereas in human resource management, the control is based on self-control. Personal management takes a reactive approach, whereas HRM takes a proactive approach. A manager with basic managerial skills can engage in personal management, but human resource management requires it to be done by a specialist or a professionally qualified person in that field. Personal management focuses on using employees for the organizational benefit or interest, while HRM focuses on harmonizing the interest of both the organization and the employees in order to achieve mutual benefit. Personal management emphasizes on complying and adhering to the rules and regulations, whereas human resource management emphasizes on the commitment of employees. Therefore, basically, human resource management is an advanced or more developed version of personal management. Now let's look at the differences between traditional HRM and strategic HRM. In traditional HRM, the responsibility of managing the employees lies with the HR department only. But in strategic HRM, that responsibility lies with all the departmental managers and HR department. In traditional HRM, role of HR is transactional, while in strategic HRM, the role of HR is transformational. Traditional HRM mainly focuses on developing people, but strategic HRM takes an integrated approach by combining the employee and organizational development in line with organizational objectives. Traditional HRM has only short-term goals, while strategic HRM has short-term, medium, and long-term goals. In traditional HRM, rules, policies, and authority is used as the basis for control, whereas in strategic HRM, the control takes a flexible approach in order to meet the necessary needs at required times. Traditional HRM is cost-centered, whereas strategic HRM focuses on investing on their employees. Traditional HRM takes reactive decisions with regard to HR issues, whereas strategic HRM takes proactive decisions with regard to HR issues. So we'll move on to the next. I will explain the line and staff aspects of HRM. Line managers are the ones who have the authority to direct their subordinates to carry out their tasks, and they are responsible for achieving the organizational objectives. Since they directly engage with the employees on a daily basis, they have a responsibility to carry out certain HR duties for the effectiveness of human resource management. For example, they are responsible for providing training for employees with regard to new projects and tasks that are assigned to them. Line managers can be found in departments such as sales and production. However, HR managers usually fall under the category of staff managers. They have the authority to assist and advise line managers in areas like recruiting, training, and grievance handling. However, both line managers and staff managers are engaged in human resource management activities. And finally, these are the most important functions of HRM. They are job design and job analysis, HR planning, recruitment and selection, performance management, reward management, training and development, employee relations, health and safety management. However, I'm not going to discuss them here as I will be discussing them in detail in our next videos. So with that, I'm going to finish our first lesson. When the rhythm starts.